seminary? That is pretty hard to define because it's a different thing to every person in it. Surely it's a school of advanced education, buildings and faculty and a curriculum. But a seminary is more than simply a school. It's more than a curriculum. A seminary is people.
In Christ there is no east or west, in him no south or north, but one great fellowship of love throughout the whole wide earth.
You see, a curriculum or a building, even the best laid out campus has no life in it. It takes people to put life in the seminary. Seminary is a way of life. It's a life in itself.
I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread which I shall give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all things, we acknowledge that you have our sins and wickedness, which we from time to time will grievously have sinned by our fault. We do ask for your repentance, and our hearts and our bodies are his own good. Remember the dead and free your son from us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all the bad, and grant us to be ever perfect, to serve and be pleased in you and our life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Serve and please thee. Serve and please thee. A seminarian often has the opportunity, if even out of necessity, to serve the rural church, which is today caught between the separation of yesterday and tomorrow. It's a great challenge to serve that church in this age. There are fewer residents on the land, less local economic strength. In fact, the one thing it has going for it is a weary drain of young people going elsewhere to find their dreams. Still, the fellowship is authentic. The need for spiritual leadership is as great or greater than ever before. Serve and please thee? Yes. The rural church may be the context in which a young man first becomes involved in civic planning or act as a local educator. Here is where he first applies social principles. A pastor in a small rural community also has the opportunity to help people in his parish recognize their growing relationship in an ever-expanding radius. No longer is the word neighbor reserved only for the fellow whose barley field is across the fence. A student charge is part of the seminary experience.
I don't know, really, at no other time in my life, whether it's in high school or college or any other time, I've ever learned that I knew so little.
Serve and please thee in the city? If the rural scene is leisurely, the city is just the opposite. Hectic motion and a busy life is the norm. A survey of the inner city points to the extended needs that are going unanswered. Low salaries, poor working conditions, those are a mark of the core area. Poor housing, a lack of sanitation, understaffed, outdated schools that are often just steps to nowhere. St. Matthew records a parable which says, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundations of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me." The inner city is often a seminarian's first opportunity to serve and please God in a primary social crisis. 1 out of 4 persons in our country today lives in suburbia, but more than twice that live in the core area. Suburbia is the rich ring around the city. It has its problems, to be sure, but the city center is where the pain is visible, where the ugliness may be ministered unto. There is rarely a sharp boundary between the rich and the non-rich. Often they live side by side. There's a multitude of possible patterns in the changing neighborhoods, at one time being race change, at another time being ethnic. The seminary experience includes a first-hand involvement with these pressing social issues. Come, O blessed of my Father, serve and please thee.
There's one aspect of seminary that has really helped me in the understanding of life. Before I came to seminary, I led a normal life, but a deprived as far as experiences were concerned within the church and without outside of the church. And at seminary, I'm a junior, and we have a pilot project which is setting up a course for next year, which is called something like Church in the World. And we've gone to different places. We rode in police cars. We went to a drug addiction school in Fort Worth, and we've been to court, and many exposures that I never would have gotten had I not gone to seminary. And I think this is one of the unacademic things that has helped me more than anything else. The academic things help, but unless they're supplemented by something that's real to you, they're not much good. My bag is counseling. I'm working as a chaplain, assistant chaplain at Methodist Hospital. And of course, ministering to the sick, when a person is hurting, he starts thinking about his spiritual well-being many times. And so I'm challenged at the hospital to pull all the existential, all the practical aspects of living out that I know and give to these people to fulfill their spiritual needs and help them grow.
There is no reason where
probably make clear is that I don't have any specific vocational use or a BD degree, and don't plan to go into the pastoral ministry. And so, in a professional sense, I suppose it can apply to that aspect of my life only insofar as it kind of enables me to get a better understanding of what kind of things are important in life and what kind of things I want to do with my life. I mean, I'm studying more from a more personal reason than that. An attempt to get some clarity on the so-called fundamental questions about what's really important in life, what you should do with your time, what kind of values are really ultimate, what kinds of whether life is meaningful or not, and what kind of things in life make it meaningful.
I think a seminary is a place in which people of varying abilities and backgrounds can come together and try to learn what it means to have the hope of life. And I think a seminary is unique in that people have such common language and common tradition and so on that they are peculiarly able to find out what it means to be a community, to be a group which is willing to be honest and to press, to take a stand on what it believes to be the truth about life.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of life and your mercy is given thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by the one offering himself a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. And it is the duty of the Holy Gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee. And grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his passion, death, and resurrection, may be partakers of the divine nature through him. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
I'd like to approach it in two ways since you put the question. Number one is in my relationship of seminary into my lifestyle, in that I see seminary has been a chance for me to put words to my relationship to God and to grow in this relationship, and also in somewhat of a quote control situation to begin to live out some lifestyles. And this also in the second respect into my ministry, I see this as my opportunity to grow, to test out, and to see other people testing out, so that in going into my ministry, then I am somewhat more stable than I was leaving college, and helping and guiding and directing those that I will work with, and working through what it means to be a Christian in the world today.
Well, I think seminary primarily for me has been probably a proving ground for my own faith and development of my own understanding of what it is to be a Christian. I don't think I can really find out this, of course, until I get out into the parish and face the what you want to call it, the existential realities of the world and the people in it.
Well, of course, regardless of when you're in seminary or whatever, it's incomplete in that the world changes. I know I graduated in 64 and now come back again, not through any fault of Perkins or not through any fault of mine. I just wanted some more, and the world had changed. Also, going into education, I just wanted more. It's a stimulus, it's a resource,
and I can say now, after spending 4 years here, 4 years of my choosing, that it has proven to be quite beneficial. I would not recommend to any young man or older man either, for that matter, to skip seminary. I've been trying to think ever since you first mentioned this to me what reason I would give for making that statement, and I think the reason is that back when I thought I knew where I was theologically, etc. I say this again in view of the fact that I was putting my own interpretation to where I thought I was. Now that I've been here and had this interpreted for me, I did not know where I was at that time.
I think that the most basic kind of preparation for seminary is preparation for life rather than professional preparation. Perhaps this isn't as it should be, but I feel like before a person can function vocationally, he has to understand the total dimension of his life. It seems to me that these have been the things that have had the greatest impact on me, is coming to direct confrontation with the Christian faith, not as it speaks to me as one who's in an ordained ministry, but rather one who is a believer, one who is in the general ministry of all Christian believers. And at that point, it seems to me it's more a preparation for living life than it is for the specific functions of a ordained clergyman.
From my experience with Huggins, is an experience that I have undertaken for the sake of improving my abilities to be a minister, both ability to understand the wisdom that is good, ability to minister within particular faith which I have in God and in His open wisdom, minister that through the several disciplines that I can learn here. The discipline of preaching, of counseling, of visiting, and many other disciplines.
I don't see seminary as having given me something with which now I'm ready to go out and dig a garden. You know what, Thomas? I see maybe it's given me a perspective with which to work or to move around in which I can keep digging at, keep looking toward, keep studying, keep moving. I heard somebody talking about skills. I have to agree with that statement that hasn't necessarily given me skills, but maybe train us to look for some skills.
I know not where the road will lead. I follow day by day. For where it ends, I only know. I walk the King's highway. Yes, I walk the King's highway. I know not if the way is long, and no one else can say.
Seminary? It's not a microcosm of all society, but a selected microcosm, in which both men and women may discover not only their gifts and graces, not only the varied uses of those graces, but also the ideal context in which they may be administered to serve and to please Thee.
When I shall know why you.
Thank you.